Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Deepa Soman, and these are the major news stories of Saturday, July 13, 2024. Rescuers recovered the body of an Indian, the first from two buses that were swept by a mudslide in Nepal into a rain-swollen river with more than 50 passengers. In the by-elections to 13 assembly seats across 7 states, India bloc won 8 and BJP 2 as of 4:30 p.m. Former PAK PM Imran Khan and wife were acquitted in an unlawful marriage case. Israeli Army Radio said Hamas military chief was targeted in Gaza strike. Women laborers discovered a treasure trove while excavating rainwater harvesting pit in Kerala. Let's get into the details. Rescuers in Nepal on Saturday recovered the body of a 40-year-old Indian national, the first from two buses that were swept by a mudslide into a rain-swollen river with more than 50 passengers. The two buses, carrying 54 passengers, including 7 Indians, went missing in the Trishuli River. The landslides happened at the Simalthal area along the Narayan Ghat Mangling Road in Chitwan on Friday. 3 people swarmed to safety later. The first body from the buses was discovered 50 kilometers away from the accident site. The deceased was identified as Rishipal Shahi from India, police said. Police also said the body was found half covered by sand in the Narayani River of Chitwan district, adding that he was carrying an Indian ID. The India Alliance has come out on top in the by-elections to 13 assembly seats across 7 states. The bloc has won 8 seats and is ahead on 2 others as of 4:30 p.m. The Bharatiya Janata Party has claimed just 2 seats. The Congress, Trinamool Congress, the Aam Aadmi Party and the Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam are the India bloc parties that fielded candidates in the by-polls held on Wednesday. They were held in Punjab, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar and Tamil Nadu. In Punjab, AAP's Mohinder Bhagat won the Jalandhar West seat by over 23,000 votes. In West Bengal, Trinamool Congress candidates have taken the lead in 4 seats, with BJP trailing behind in each constituency. Himachal Chief Minister Sukhvinder Singh Sukhu's wife Kamlesh Thakur, who made her electoral debut, won the Dera elections. In the state, the Congress has been leading in Nalagarh too, while BJP's Ashish Sharma is ahead in Hamirpur. In West Bengal, the TMC has won 4 seats, with its candidates defeating BJP opponents by significant margins. In Tamil Nadu, the DMK's Anniyur Shiva is leading by 58,785 votes in the Vikravandi assembly seat. A Pakistan court acquitted former Prime Minister Imran Khan and his wife Bushra Khan on Saturday on charges of unlawful marriage. This is a day after his party won more seats in parliament, ramping up pressure on the country's fragile government. Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf party said there were no more cases pending against him. The couple were sentenced to 7 years in February. This was when a court found them guilty of breaking Islamic law by failing to observe the required interval between Bushra's divorce from a previous marriage and her marriage to Khan. Israeli Army Radio said on Saturday its military had targeted Hamas military chief in a strike on Khan Yunis in Gaza. This was a strike that the enclave's health ministry said had killed at least 20 Palestinians. Army Radio said it was unclear whether Hamas military chief Muhammad Deif was killed. The Israeli military said it was looking into the report. The Gaza Health Ministry said in a statement that Nasser Hospital in Khan Yunis received 20 bodies and 90 wounded. The statement didn't give a final figure of victims moved to other medical facilities. A group of women laborers never imagined that they would unearth a treasure trove in Kerala's Kannur. The women were digging up a rainwater harvesting pit at a private rubber plantation. The container they stumbled upon was filled with precious jewels and old coins, which is considered to be of great value. Though its value and antiquity can be ascertained only after a detailed examination by the archaeology department, it is considered as an invaluable treasure trove by the locals. After being informed of the discovery, police rushed to the spot and collected the treasure on Thursday itself. Later, they produced the jewels and coins before a local court. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Deepa Soman, and produced by Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow on Manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.